will make it at the end to 1,200.
Got the reading, okay? Pressure 1, pressure 2, and pressure 3. And also the flow rate, and the flow.
And then, press 2, 8, 1.
Now, at position 1, and then suddenly, you take the reading, okay? Take the reading. Position 5, and then again you take the reading.
Until you go to 10.
Okay. And you repeat the step up to position 10. Okay. And don't forget to take the reading.
You have to make sure the RPM is maintained at 1,200.
Okay.
Because when we increase, the RPM will drop.
So every time you have to make sure that the speed is constant at 1,200. Okay. Then only you take the reading.
What you can take, example, you can take this.
So this is at constant speed, but at different blade position.
If you get the position for your next experiment is 5, so we set it to 5. So this is 5. We don't change this. So what you need to change is your RPM. You can set your RPM from the higher to lower or lower to higher. So, but I prefer take it from higher to lower. Okay? So you take it as high as you can, because you want to make a bigger difference. If you make a smaller difference, when you plot, you cannot get a beautiful graph. So you have to make a big difference, like drop 200 200 or 300 RPM. For example, you start from 1500 RPM, you drop it 1300, and then drop more 1100. So we get a big difference, and you can get a big number. Okay, now we spin it until you go to the maximum. Start from 1,600. go through and down. Okay, one.